Hello friends, here in this video we will see what are the theories of failure. Let us get started. The theories of failure, in total there are four theories of failure, and they are the first one is called as Oren's theory. Second, it is called as Wood's theory. Third, it is called as Cottrill and Hull theory. And the fourth one is called as Mott theory. So now we have these four theories of failure, or they can also be said as theories of fatigue failure, because ultimately out of each of the theories, if we see, we are able to understand how the cracks are formed, and then there is certainly a fatigue fracture due to the crack formation. So first, Oren's theory, I'll say that the description of the above theory are, now the first one is Oren's theory. Now as per this theory, there are some weak regions within a material wherein the slip can take place, and there are some metallurgical, that is from the metallurgical point of view, there are some inclusions in the material, and when we are loading that material beyond a region of plastic deformation, then the cracks are formed. So here I'll write down that Oren's theory, it states that in a material there are some weak regions which are favorable for slip, and there are metallurgical, I'll continue here, inclusions in the material. So when the material is loaded or stressed beyond the plastic region, comma, cracks are formed. So here I have written the statement regarding Oren's theory. It states that if in a material there are some weak regions, and if there are weak regions, failure will start, or slipping of the layers will start from that weak region, that is which are favorable for slip, and there are metallurgical inclusions, that is at the time of forming of that metal or materials, there are some inclusions or some impurities in the metal. So when the material is loaded with, or it is stressed beyond the plastic region, then the cracks are formed, and finally there will be fracture. So this is Oren's theory. Next we have Wood's theory. Now Wood's theory, for example, it states that there are slip movements due to fatigue, that is fatigue, it is a kind of repetitive, or we can say continuous loading, wherein the stress value changes or the nature of stress changes. So it states that there are slip movements due to fatigue, and if the slip of layers take place by 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter, then extrusions or notches are formed within the material, and when the extrusions or notches are formed, so when extrusions or notches are formed, then cracks will start propagating from those weak regions. That is, whenever we are forming or we are getting notches or extrusions in the material, then cracks will start forming from that weak regions. Weak regions are where the area changes, that is extrusions or notches or internal grooves. So here I can explain it with a diagram of slip planes. Here, as I can see, there are slip planes. Now, because of the slip planes movement, here as I can see, because of the movement of the slip planes over one another, there is notch formed in the material. And because of the notch formation, because these are the slip layers, and when the layers they are slipping in this way, so a gap or a groove is formed, and then the fracture will start from here. Similarly, there are chances that due to the movement of the slip planes, there will be extrusions formed. These are called as extrusions, that is some part of the material will be projected outside. So because of the movement of the slip planes, either notch can be formed or extrusions, and when the notches or extrusions are formed, crack will start propagating from the notches, or it will start propagating from the extrusion, because here the area has suddenly changed. So this was regarding Wood's theory. The next third theory is, it is Cottrill and Hull theory. So now, in Cottrill and Hull theory, I'll write down the statement for it. It states that a model which, or a model involving the edge dislocation in two different directions result in the formation of extrusion or intrusion within the material, that is Cottrill and Hull theory. It first of all states that it is giving a model or an example involving the edge dislocation in two different directions, means that there are two different directions from which the edge gets dislocated, direction result in the formation of extrusion or intrusion. Either extrusion is formed or intrusion within the material. Then if there are extrusion and intrusion, how it will look like? I'll just draw the diagram and explain. Now, see in this diagram, here I have denoted S1 and S2. They are called as slip planes. Next, as we can see, this is a given material and because of the edge dislocation, this is the edge, and now because of slipping, this edge gets dislocated inside. So this inside dislocation is called as intrusion, and then there is, because of slip of S1 region or S1 plane, there is an extended part, that is from the edge some part gets extended. So this is called as extrusion. And when the intrusions and extrusions are formed, then cracks will start forming from the intrusion and extrusion, because here the area has changed. Area becomes minimum, so stress is maximum. So we can say that, therefore, as per Cottrill and Hull's theory, the material when loaded or stressed, then cracks will start propagating from intrusions or extrusions. So now, as per Cottrill and Hull's theory, the material when loaded or stressed, then cracks will start propagating from intrusions or extrusions, which are formed, as I have explained it with the diagram, that how the intrusion and extrusion are formed because of the slip planes which are moving in opposite directions. So failure or cracks will propagate from intrusions or extrusion. Failure will start, cracks are going to form at the intrusion or extrusion, because here the areas, they are less. So I can say that, hence fatigue failure will take place. That is, after the cracks are formed, then the fatigue failure will take place. Next, the last theory, which is called as Mott theory. Now here it states that because of screw dislocations, a column of material is removed from the component and it will leave a cavity in the material, and so when the cavity is formed, cracks will start propagating from these cavities, and it will result in fatigue failure. So here, as per Mott theory states that because of screw dislocations, a column of material, that is a part of material, is removed from the component, and when the part is removed, it will result in cavity or some space which is formed inside the material, and when the cavity is formed, cracks will start propagating. That is, when the cavity is formed, material is applied with some load, then cracks will start forming from that cavity, and finally it will result in fatigue failure. So here in this video we have seen four theories of failure, that is Oren's theory, then we have seen a Wood's theory, Cottrill and Hull theory, and finally Mott theory.